Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. before we play the second half, just for you flute fans, which I think, I guess you all are.
Yeah.
We just thought we'd tell you a little bit about our instruments, because our instruments are just like, they're a little unusual, because they're not so new. Well, Christina should go first, because she has like this really amazing instrument that is, there are only six of these instruments in the world. So, you tell
them. This is a Powell, and it's solid platinum, and for those of you super observant people out there, you can see it's just a one-piece body, there's no foot joint. And it was made in 1938, handmade by Powell, and I think possibly the reason he made it as a one-piece body is because he was unfamiliar with the metal and he just was worried about the tube vibrating, so he made it as an all one-piece. I think the other five that he handmade, the platinum ones, were all have a foot joint, so this is the only one that doesn't have the foot joint, and it was made for Joseph Mariano, who then sold it to a bunch of people. One of them was my predecessor in the Atlanta Symphony, who was principal flute in the ASO, Warren Little, who was there for 50 years, and I ended up buying it from a family member of his about 6 years ago. But the weird thing is that the other flute that I owned that I played for like my whole career in Atlanta was also a handmade Powell made in 1938, and it's made out of silver. So I have these two Powells that are two serial numbers apart, which is really cool.
My story's not that interesting. The only thing I can say about this flute is that it's just a little older than Christina's. And if you're an old Powell person. So this is a Powell 245, and this is from 1936. And it was made for a guy, I believe, named Mitch Miller, but not the famous conductor Mitch Miller, but a guy who was an amateur flutist and a lawyer in Philadelphia. And so the nice thing about it is that it spent a lot of its life until I got it in a safe. So it's in very immaculate condition. Well, it was in immaculate condition until about 10 years ago when I got my hands on it. So it's just a lot of fun to play with two old pals because, you'll see, it's just fun. Some Mendelssohn. Or do we want tune? No tune. Spoil the surprise.
We're among friends.
Thank you.
principal flute player of the Atlanta Symphony up to play a recital with you and not play that. Now for something completely different. I'm going to stand over here. This Busoni duo is, I think, my favorite duo. And every time I play with another flutist, I make them play this piece with me. And they always like it at the end. And it's a piece, you know, Busoni, of course, was this famous pianist, turn of the century guy and composer. But what most people don't know is that he played the flute as a kid. And so this is a counterpoint piece that he wrote when he was 14. And I love it because it sounds sort of like, well, to me it sounds like if Bach had gone to Hungary and like hung out with Brahms or something, he would have written this piece. So, Busoni duo.
Thank you.
I'm going back to where I belong. Second flute chair. There are a few things in life that you can be sure of, right? Death and taxes. And the third is, if two flutists are going to play a recital, there's going to be a piece of Doppler. This is his. Wonderfully, this is one of his greatest works. Most profound.
Thank you.
Shorter than that looks. Actually, it's going to take less time than my setup.
Mine looks pretty long.
All right. You'll all recognize.